moves that House Resolution 1003, as found on page 480 of the House Journal, be adopted.
Second.
That motion having been made and seconded in regard to House Resolution 1003, are there any comments? Representative Hansen.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker, members of the body. I don't offer you this resolution lightly. I know that this body can tire of resolutions that have no force of law. But there does come a time when the state of South Dakota, through its elected representatives, cannot remain silent and must speak. This is one of those times. Never have I experienced a time where South Dakotans from all walks of life have approached me and others and expressed such sadness and horror like the people have upon hearing about the passage of the recent New York abortion law, which permits an abortion of children in the last moment of life, before the life beyond the womb. We express our shock and our sorrow for the people of New York. They have fallen into making the same grave mistake as our own United States Supreme Court did when it decided Roe versus Wade. And I offer you this often undiscussed but probably most important sentence in the Roe versus Wade decision. The court actually said, and I quote, "We need not resolve the difficult question of when life begins." End quote. We need not resolve the difficult question of when life begins. And sadly, New York has made that same mistake today. South Dakota recognizes that from the moment of conception, an abortion terminates the life of a whole, separate, unique, living human being. The sacred relationship between a mother and her child is the core of all civilized culture, and its denigration is the denigration of the human race. So there are some from New York that call us flyover country. Some call us uneducated. But we recognize humanity when we see it. We mourn for the loss of all beautiful, innocent, unborn human lives who have fallen victim to the unspeakable crime of abortion. So to our fellow Americans in the great state of New York, I want you to know that the people of South Dakota are honestly, humbly praying for you, for the conversion of your hearts, that one day you too would know that an abortion terminates the life of a whole, separate, unique, living human being, and that this horrific genocide must end.